Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So students, in the last lecture we have studied that what is integrated rate law for first order reaction, and now we are going to learn that what is half life, and we will derive an equation based on half life for the integrated first order reaction. So students, before understanding or before deriving that half life for the first order reaction, it is very important for us to understand what is half life. Half life is nothing but the time required to convert the initial concentration of the reactant to its half value. So let us see the definition and let us derive an equation which will be based on the half life for integrated rate law for first order reaction. So let us see the definition. According to the definition, the time needed for the reactant concentration to fall to one half of its initial concentration. Suppose if I give you an example, the initial concentration of a reactant is 100 moles per dm cube. So the time required to convert to its half, that means the time required to convert that 100 moles per dm cube to its half, that is 50 moles per dm cube, that time requirement is known as half life. Half life for every reactant can be different. So let us see that on what basis and on what it depends. So let us derive an equation for the half life. As we know, for the first order reaction, the rate constant can be derived as K is equals to 2.303 divided by T log to the base 10 of concentration of A0 divided by 8. But half life, it is denoted by T half. Here the time is T. So according to half life, it means the time required to convert the initial concentration to its half. So in that case, when I have to convert the initial concentration to its half, it means finally I will get a concentration of the reactant which will be half of the initial value, which means at half life I will denote the time as T half and the final concentration of the reactant, it will be half of its initial. That means the value of AT will be initial concentrations half. So at half life, let us substitute these values and let us see what do we get. We'll get K is equals to 2.303 divided by, instead of T we will write T half. This is log to the base 10. A0 will be as it is because we cannot change the initial concentration, but the final concentration is always changing and we have to make it till its half. So therefore the final concentration will be A0 divided by 2. So let us equate this thing to further extent. So we will get K is equals to 2.303 divided by T half. T half is nothing but the half life log to the base 10 of A0 divided by A0 into 2. So in this case A0 and A0 will get cancelled out with each other, and the value which is left with us is log of 2. So let me tell you, the value of log 2 is 0.3010. So if we multiply this both things, we will get a value of 0.693 divided by t half, and this is the value of rate constant for a half-life reaction for the first order reaction. So what will be the unit of this thing? Again, you can see the t half is present, means the unit of time is nothing but, it can be seconds, it can be minutes. So for a small instance, suppose I take the unit as seconds. So what will be the rate constant for the half-life? It would be nothing but second inverse. So this is the unit of rate constant for the half-life for the first order reaction. And as you can also see, this rate constant is not dependent on the concentration. While in the case of integrated rate law for the first order reaction, we have observed that the rate constant K is dependent on A0 as well as it is also dependent on AT. But for half-life, it is not dependent on the concentration of reactant. It is independent on the concentration of reactant. So this is what we have calculated, or we have estimated and derived an equation for rate constant for half-life. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video, and please share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.